well. As we can see, it is not impossible that a great person such as Professor Hengland was, like any other human being, subject to collective hallucinations.